some time. We're going to go over the limit because we started late, so we have some good time for questions. So maybe I'll ask you to identify yourself before you ask the question. I think we have microphones on both sides. Are they going to be staying there, or are they going to be floating? Okay. Why don't you give the mic over here, please?
Hi, Alex Bueno Edwards, NYU School of Law. I have a question for you, and my question is, on the agenda of freedom that you speak of in the search for Muslim democracy, I mean, you've mentioned Turkey certainly as an advancing light in the democratic Muslim world, but even in Turkey, there is very circumscribed freedom of conscience for non-Muslims, one could argue. Certainly there's not any liberty for people who are Muslim to convert to another religion. And surely that must be considered as a fundamental freedom, not to have to be a Muslim for life, right? So, but even in a country like Turkey, that's nowhere near on the agenda. So where does that fall in this search for democracy, that the actual freedom of conscience to not be Muslim anymore in a majority Muslim state?
The advance that you have seen in Turkey is not only indigenous or in character, but also because of the engagement with the EU. This is, to my mind, very critical. It has helped the ruling party and the liberal elements in Turkey to navigate through this pressures on EU, which is not confined to Turkey, but there are standard agreements that apply to all EU members, those that have applied or wish to be members of EU. And to my mind, this is of enormous assistance in the maturing process and towards reform in Turkey. Secondly, you must also realize that the military establishment is a major factor and still has an immense influence and pressure against democratic leadership in Turkey. And it is only through the EU pressure, and I believe to a large extent American pressure, that you can then manage to confine the military establishment in their barracks. But specifically on the issue of conversion, I think it's also internal dynamics and debate within the Muslim communities. I mean, there is a debate in Malaysia, in Indonesia, in Turkey, and in the Middle East that I'm aware of. In fact, there's a recent publication by the IIIT, Islamic Thought, by Sheikh Taha, that made this strong reference to this, that the issue of death penalty for those who, Muslims who convert to other religions is not tenable in law. And for example, you find this sort of arguments surfacing. But I wouldn't, for purely practical considerations, to go on these specific moves and sacrifice the general reform and agenda and freedom in the societies. And I think we have to smartly navigate your way and get this debate across so that Muslims in Turkey and elsewhere are aware. But this is one example. Like gender issues, there's still some who speak strongly on the issue of two female versus one male witness in courts. I mean, many classical scholars and known religious scholars have debunked this thesis. But this is, of course, growing as a debate, and it is within the internal dynamics of Muslim discourse.